Yes, students, can you see the PPT? Please respond.
Yes, ma'am.
You can see the PPT. No, can you see the PPT now? Please respond, because today first time I am using this, so I wanted to check whether you can see the screen or not. Can you see the PPT?
What you can see the.
No, now.
Yes, ma'am.
Now you can see.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So in last class, students. Please, all of you, mute yourself. Mute yourself. If you want to speak, only then you unmute and speak. Otherwise, mute yourself. So, students, in class. You can see my screen now. Please mute yourself. So students, in last class, we were discussing about the organization of a report. So in the organization of a report, we have seen some of the important points, that is the nature and the extent of outlining, introductory and conclusion part, and organization of division. So I'll 2 minutes, I'll repeat. See, this outlining is nothing but the agenda. You can see the screen now, students. What about others? Why only so many students are present today? Why only 10 students are present today?
Because, ma'am, morning.
Because of first hour class?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay. The outline is nothing but it contains the agenda, or it contains the it is like a content page. It is like a outline is nothing but it is like a content page. What the content page tell us? What your document contains. Before we going through the whole documents, if you see the content, we'll understand what all the document contains. So that is nothing but a extra outline of the document. Introductory and conclusion part means the introductory part contains the introduction of your project or introduction of your report. That report is nothing but on which agenda or which outline you have prepared the report. In that, the introductory part contains the introduction of the report, and the concluding part contains the conclusion of the report, and organization by division. See, if you take a report of a software project, then the content data of the report will be different. If you take a report of a software project, the data of the report will be different. So based on the categories or based on the agenda, the division will be depend. So organizing the data is very important. Here in last class, we have seen the organization of a data. There will be two types: conventional system and decimal system. See, in conventional system, so this is a way, first heading, and next is a subheading. This is a subheading of second. This is first phase. This is second phase. See here, in second phase, second level, first part. Again, second level, first part. If I include C here, then second level, third part. Now again, I'm changing the level. So if I change the level, I'm changing the hierarchy of the number. See, this is Roman I, capital A, digit 1, small a, the digit 1 within the bracket. If you change, if you divide further, then I may give in square bracket 1, or next I may give in flower bracket 1. So like that, you can change. So similarly, we have a decimal system. we have a decimal system. So here we are in conventional part, we are conveying the number. So here we are representing the number in a decimal point. See here, first 1.1, 1.2, 1.2.1, 1.2.2, next 1.2.2.1. So like that, we are changing the order. So now we have how to write. You are able to listen, me now, students? Yes. Now next we have how to write memos, how to write resume, and how to write letters. When you write a letter, when you want to communicate, or when you want to convey some message to the other person, then we write a letter. It's nowadays this social media has come, so that's why we are not using much of letter. Correct? No. Otherwise, in our olden days, we used to when we were small, when we were kids. So that time, our parents used to write a letter to their parents. Correct? No. So now, because of technology improvement, we are using more of social media. So letters we are not using much to communicate personally. But in some situations, when you want to talk any official things, then definitely we have to use a letters. So is there any some of the standard letter formats will be there. I'll show you. So here the first thing is how to write a letter. So there to write a letter, there will be standard format. So based on the format, the I think when you are in school, I think you have studied writing a letter to parents will be different format. Writing a letter to teacher will be different format. Correct? No. So there will be different formats. So now when suppose you want to convey anything to your head of the department or to your faculty, then you orally also you can tell, but if it is necessary, then we may tell you to write a letter. If you want to take permission for anything, this letter is also like to keep a proof also we can keep this letter. Next, physical representation of memo. What is memo? Any idea? Memo also actually it is a memorandums, but we in short we call as a memo. Actually it is a students, you are able to see this. All of you are able to see the screen now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Wait 1 minute. I'll put one message in the group once again. Why many of the students are not coming regularly to the classes? That we'll see later. So now next we have memo. See, memo is also not. See, in letter, what I told, if you want to convey something or convey any message, we use letters. So similarly, if you want to convey any message or for communication purpose, we use this memo. See, letters we use we use within the organization and outside the organization also. But this memo, in most of the cases, this memos will be used within the organization only. But only in rare cases, we use outside the organization. Memorandums are nothing but a notice or the message which you want to communicate within the organization. So that's why here I have written memos are a form of letters written inside the business. Rare case communicating outside the business. So this is mainly, you will get a 15th August holiday. So that is a government holiday. But we all know that is a government holiday. Or we will also get a notice, or we will also get a memo from office that on 15th August there will be holiday. Yes. So that information they are communicating within the organization only. So that also that message also we can say as a memo. Yes, students, understanding? So this message memo are a form of letters which are used to communicate within the business or within the organization and outside the organization also. And usually the memos will be hard copy. Usually the memos will be hard copy. Only in the rare cases we use a soft copy. So generally the memos will be a hard copy. So you understood the difference between letter and memo? Next, determining memo format. So of memo form, for memos there will be a different formats. In some situations the format of the memos based on the organization also. For example, BMSIT, maybe they may follow a standard format. The heading may be memo. Heading may be memo with a colon, or I'll show you. Students, are you able to see my screen? This word blank page. What you can see on the screen? Students, please respond.
Yes, ma'am.
Word page, you can see blank word page.
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Okay. See here, assume that in my department,
Ma'am, can you zoom this Word file, ma'am?
Yes.
Can you zoom this, ma'am?
Wait. I'm increasing the font size. Now you can see?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
See here. See, there is no necessary that for memo, we have to follow the same format or a standard format like letter. Top left, right corner, date should be there. Left corner, two address should be there, and then after the two address, then respected sir, then the subject respected sir, like the how the format will be there. No, so here in memo it is not like that. Based on my convenient, I can change my format. So this is my standard format. Assume that here I have included the college logo also. So memo here I may include date, so this holiday memo I use to circulate only holidays. Thank you. occasion. Yes, student, you are able to see word document.
Yes, ma'am.
This may be one format. Next, the other format. Circular. Circular is nothing but to convey any message like placement training, extra class, see it is not compulsory that I have to use only this. Students, see here, I have typed the samples of two memos. Memo one, this is for holidays, to announce any holidays to my students. I'm using this format and to circulate any information, like it may be any extra class or placement training or any test, some message I want to communicate. So this is the two formats I'm using. See, in this format, the occasion I'm giving means on which, what occasion I'm announcing a holiday and date and number of days, 1 day, 2 days, 3 days. See here, the second format of a memo, date, reason means for what reason or what is the reason why this circular I'm circulating? Is it a extra class or is it a placement training or is it a placement class or is it a placement test and the timing? See, students, don't get confused. These are all very simple topics. In very simple way, I'm explaining. See, we are going to study letters, memos, and resume. You know how to create resume. That we'll discuss later. But memo. See, all these are simple information that we are going to circulate only in our organization. Here they have used the word business, but here I'm using the word department or organization. This information, this is a local communication media, local communication. So here you can use any way, whatever the way you want to represent. This is one format I have taken to announce a memo, and this is another format I have taken to announce a memo. See here, this memo is for holiday and this memo is for some circulation, some circular. Understanding, students? Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So there will be, first you have to determine the form of the memos and viewing the memo formality. What is formality? What is the general meaning of formality?
Ma'am, to complete some task in a formal way, that
yes,
we have to do that.
Yes. And so you see here, see if you see the word document, in this memo, I include one more memo for assignment. Assignment. Submission date. Submission date. Submission date I am including. And if you want to include time also before 4:30. See, why I am typing all this? Just to show the different ways of memo and to compare with these points. So I am telling in my memo, I am telling in this, within this time you have to finish your formality, correct? Within this time, what is your formality to submit the assignment? To submit the assignment, I am giving the deadline to the students. So writing the memos, is depends on the situations. If you want to communicate about any, whatever the message, if you want to communicate to your listeners, see here, the listeners are my students. In an organization, if you take a principal, the listeners are students and the faculties. So wherever the speaker changes, even the listeners also changes. If you take only the faculties, then the listeners may be only students. If you take the speaker principal, then the listeners may be staff and the students. If you take speakers as management, then the listeners are principal, faculties and the students. So based on the situations, the conveying of the memos will be different. So here we have to understand the writing of memo and policy memo and directives. So simply I cannot write any memo. There will be some policy, standard policies will be there. So based on the policies, I have to write the memo. And next we have resume. You all know. So before I start the resume, I'll show you. You can see the word document, students.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Here, from internet, I have taken some of the example of the memo. See here, example one, general office memo. See, this is general office memo to all staff from manager. Yes, and the date, subject, to whom he is writing, and what is the memo. Yes, this is one way of, or this is one example of writing memo. See here, the manager is writing to his staff. See, when you say manager is writing to writing memo to staff, it may be of the whole organization. It may be to the whole organization. See here, one more example, a memo to the department. A memo to the within the department. The memo within the department. See here, this is a second example. See here, specifically he has mentioned this is only for the computer science, computer programming division. So this memo is for whole staff. And this memo is for only for one department. Yes. So the meaning of this is, to write a memo, there is no standard format. So based on our requirement, we can change. So from whom we are getting a memo, and date and subject and what we want to convey, that we can write here. So that is nothing but a memo. Yes, students understood what is memo? So next we have a very important topic, resume, constructing resume. You all know how to prepare a resume. See, again in resume, if you see some of the resume, when you see a resume, in some resumes, the heading will be resume, or if you some may follow the heading, they don't give resume, they just mention their names. Yes, students, you observe this now? Some students or some people give the heading as resume, some people they don't give a heading as resume. They don't use resume word in their headings. Just they begin with the heading as by their names. Yes, correct, no? So when we prepare a resume, here are some of the traditional points we have to remember to prepare a resume. The first one is selecting the background fact. Selecting the background fact. What is the background fact? See, for marriage proposal also we give resume. For job also we give resume. Correct, no? Yes, students. So each will be of same format, same facts with the same background. No, the format of professional resume will be different from format of marriage proposal resume. So based on the theme, we have the theme is nothing but based on the background, we have to highlight the points in our resume. In professional resume, what we give? Name, date of birth, where we have studied, how much percentage we got in SSLC 12th, in your graduation and in your MC post-graduation. So that is for formal or for job purpose, we use that format of resume. Whereas for marriage proposal, then your family details will be there, your siblings details will be there, your personal details will be there. Yes, no? So based on the situation, we have to select the facts to include in the resume. Arranging fact into groups. So with respect to your personal resume and with respect to your professional resume, both, we have to understand what should be included first and how to arrange. First, your name. If you take your professional resume, first your name. Then if you're already in job, then first you will explain about your current experience and where you have worked. Then you'll the previous organization where you have worked. There the marks or the percentage will not play much role because already you are in job. If you are a fresher, when you want to apply when you are applying first time, then you will include your academic details first. You'll highlight your academics details. If you take example of your marriage proposal resume, there you'll highlight your family background, how sound your family, and what is the qualification, what is the quality of your siblings. So based on the situations, we are the arrangement of the facts will be changing. Constructing heading is very important in resume. Hobbies, when we are mentioning any hobbies in your resume, then actually you should
సట్ట ఇట్ బాండే. క్లాస్ ముగితా
అయితా
హా బంగారు
Hello, is anyone there? Everyone is there.
Yeah, tell me.
Class is over or there?
There.
Where is ma'am?
Left.
Then how come class will be there?
5 minutes wait.
Yeah, how is your corona holidays, Amit?
Very bad and very good.
Bad and very good. Where are you? Are you in Bangalore?
No.
Then? Your hometown?
Yeah.
Very good.
And where are you?
I'm in native. Adi?
ಮಲ್ಕೊಂಡಿರಂಗ ಡಿಸ್ಟರ್ಬ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ರೆ
ಮತ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಯಾಕೋ ಕೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ಯಾ
ಆ ಕೇಳ್ತಿರೋದು
ಸುಮ್ನೆ ಆನ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಇಟ್ಬಿಡದ
ಹೋ ಮತ್ತೆ
ಹೆಂಗಾಯ್ತು ಬರ್ಡೇ
ಬರ್ಡೇ ರಕ್ಕಣ
ಹೆವಿ ಕೇಕ ಒಂದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ಒಂದು
ಒಂದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ಒಂದು ಒಂದರ 70 ರೂಪಾಯಿ ಇಬ್ಬಿದ್ರು
ಯಾರು ಬಂದಿಲ್ಲ ಓಕೆ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್ ಬಂದ್ರು
ಸಾರಿ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ವೈಫೈ ಗಾಟ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕನೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಗಾಟ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕನೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಸೊ ಯು ಆರ್ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಸಿ ದ ಸ್ಕ್ರೀನ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಸಿ ದ ಸ್ಕ್ರೀನ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ Students, you are able to see the screen?
Yes, ma'am. No, ma'am.
It's abstract. Abstract. You are not able to see abstract.
No, ma'am.
Wait, I'll check once. Now you can see the abstract?
No, ma'am.
Abstract. Please mute yourself. If you are not speaking, mute yourself. Mm. Now you can see the screen. Okay, fine. So not only in the resume, in whatever the document you prepare, there the way of presentation is very important. Assume that you have prepared a document. Prepared a document. In that document, assume that 3-4 paragraphs are there. The size.
Ma'am, we can't see the screen, ma'am.
You can't see the screen.
Yes, ma'am.
No.
No, ma'am.
No, no, also.
No, ma'am.
Okay. No.
No, ma'am.
So, which is comfortable? Zoom is comfortable, or Hangout is comfortable? Which is comfortable for you people?
Both, ma'am.
Both. No, can you see the screen? PPT?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. In all the documents, the way of representation is very important. I think you have heard the word consistency. Consistency is nothing but if you are using a font size of a document, of a whole document, 12, then in the whole document, you have to use only 12. For the content, see again the heading of again the when you take any document, the headings will be different. Not headings, the font size will be different. For example, for main heading, the main heading, the font size will be 16. For subheading, the font size is 12, and for the content, the font size is 12. So this is the standard format we use to prepare any document. So assume that you have prepared a document of 10 page. In one page, for the content, you have given the font size 12. In the other page, if you have given the font size 8. And in the third page, if you have given the font size, for content I'm talking, not for the headings. If you're in the third page for the content, if you have given the font size 16, is there any consistency? Is there a proper way of representation any information? No. So when you represent any information in your document, it should be proper. It should have some consistency, some standard format we have to follow. So that's why in the resume also, whatever the in the resume, you will give the heading academic qualification, work experience, online courses, hobbies. So like that, you will mention a different headings in your resume. Each suppose you have 10 headings in your resume, all 10 headings should be of same font size and font style. One heading I cannot give the font size 16, the other heading I should not give the font size 12, or the next heading I should not give heading font size 20. So how many headings I have in my document, all headings I should be same. So that is a proper way of representing any data in the document. Understood how to prepare resume? So here we are done with module 2. In next class, I'll begin with module 3. So in this week, I'll conduct one assessment on module 2. Is it okay, students? Before one day, I'll inform you about the assessment, and I'll give you 2 hours time to complete your assessment. Is it okay for you? Yes, students. Shall I end the class? See, here we have completed two modules. We have completed two modules. So from next class, we'll begin with the third module. So in another one, in this week, I'll try to take one assessment test. Okay. Shall I stop here? Or you want to tell anything? You want to share any information?
No, ma'am.
Okay. We'll see in the next class.